वेलकम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 5B टू माय जीके क्लास. टुडे ए मिसलेनियस लेसन आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू. दोज हु आर स्टडीइंग कंप्यूटर दे विल लाइक इट वेरी मच. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ द नॉलेज फॉर कंप्यूटर. I shall ask you some questions. You yourself answer me. I can't hear since it is not live class. But you yourself answer it. And if you don't have any knowledge of it, you learn it from me. And then keep it in your mind. Here there are some full form written in here. Some abbreviation is there. Now you have to write it properly. You see here some questions are there, full form. You have to make its abbreviation. PC, what is the full form of PC? What is the full form of ISP? What is the full form of ID? Full form of SIM? Full form of SMS? And next one, full form of CPU, full form of RAM, full form of WWW. So these are the things you have to solve. Now what is the full form of PC? The full form of PC is, program computer. The full form of PC is, program computer. What is the full form of ISP? The full form of ISP is Internet Service Provider. Internet Service Provider. And next, ID. What is the full form of ID? The full form of ID is Instruction Decoder. The full form of ID is Instruction Decoder. And next one, SIM. What is the full form of SIM? The name of this full form SIM is Subscriber Identity Module. Subscriber Identity Module. And next full form of SMS means. No. First SIM. Full form of SIM. Short message service. Now full form of SMS. SIM, Subscriber Identity Module, and SMS, Short Message Service. What is the full form of SMS? Short Message Service. And next question, who discovered internet? Vinton Jacquard discovered internet. And next one, who discovered Hotmail? Sabir Bhatia discovered Hotmail. And the next one, what is the full form of CPU? The full form of CPU is Central Processing Unit. What is the full form of RAM? Random access memory. The full form of RAM is random access memory. What is the full form of WWW? The full form of WWW is World Wide Web. World Wide Web. The full form of WWW is World Wide Web. So these are the important things you just learned from me. Now you have to answer it. What is about it? Before learning all these things what I taught you, some points you have to keep it in your mind. What is computer and why does it require in our everyday life? Nowadays in our everyday life, computer has become an essential part of knowledge. Without computer we can't do any work. Without computer, working load which a person earlier has to shoulder, nowadays it is not possible. Nowadays, the work has become very much, easier to us because of the working load. Nowadays, computer is soldering. So, computer is a part and parcel of our everyday life. That's why computer learning is very important to us. Another thing, from historical point of view, I would like to give you some ideas, some knowledge. During medieval period, the Mughals came to India and established their rule. Emperor Akbar was not only the great Mughal ruler of India, but also a great ruler of our country, India indeed. Why? Because of his foreign policy. Whatever he adopted gave India a confidence, gave India a place of peaceful people who could enjoy their democratic rights during that very age where conservative people also were there. Conservative people always interrupted the way of growth and development. But it was Emperor Akbar who did not leave any opportunity for them. Only because of that reason, there came a remarkable development in the field of reformation, because Akbar himself was not only an emperor but also a great reformer. He received no education from any school or any university or any college, although there during that time there was no college or university during the period when the Mughals started ruling our country. Only university was there at Nalanda University, Taxila University, but it was not a part of that area from where the Mughals started ruling our country. In a nutshell, we can say that Akbar received no education, no formal education, no school education, but his thirst for knowledge was compared to sea. That's why he stressed on equality before law. Everyone was given equal right. Everyone had right to protest. Everyone could protest. Everyone could come and get their problem solved. Akbar also allowed them to get it, brought it to his notice. As soon as he came to know about their problems, he always tried to solve it. And hence, during medieval age, the rule of the Mughals had become famous only because of the rule of Akbar. Akbar did not spend money unnecessarily. As a result of it, the financial condition of the under the rule of the Mughals had become very, very much stable. During the time when Shah Jahan came During the time after the period of Akbar or at the end of Akbar's rule, who came to power? You know, Akbar's son Jahangir. Jahangir was astonished to see the khazana or financial, financial credibility of the under the Mughals. Why is it? Because Akbar did not spend unnecessary amount of money. Although he, constructed many mosques, many buildings, but what he could make, he couldn't do it. But he just saved money for the next generation, so that the person who would come after him must protect his kingdom from foreign attacks and must make his army powerful. That's why Jahangir, on being emperor after Akbar, he followed the same technique, same method, whatever Akbar adopted. But afterwards, Jahangir's son Khurram came to power in the name of Shah Jahan. He started spending a lot of money for constructing buildings, mosques of beautiful style and architecture. He wanted to communicate a message to the people of the whole world that what the Mughals didn't do, now they are going to do it under the rule of him. That's why he called a number of architects, masons, craftsmen, engineers, to give him their best efforts for the cause of Mughal art of painting, Mughal art of architecture, and Mughal art of, Mughal art of literary works and achievements. Every sphere of life, he left no stone unturned to convey a message to the people of the whole world that the Mughals constructed that buildings of good style, technique, and architecture. The people of the world would never forget it. Up to this, my dear students, this lesson is not a part of our book. This is miscellaneous part. Since I am teaching both the two sections, I may set up some questions from here also. You please take it down. Whatever I taught today, please take it down in your copies. But whatever I would like to do, I must do in consultation with you. Since priority goes to you, you may ask this question, sir, this topic is not a part of our book, then why are you setting up this question? If you allow me, in that case, I shall set up question, otherwise not. But what is required most is your knowledge. What I taught today, please keep it in your mind, learn it properly, it will become helpful to you in the long run. After this, thank you, my dear students.